हेलो एवरीवन, वेलकम बैक टू विज्ञान एकेडमी फॉर मैथ्स एंड साइंस। आई एम श्रद्धा पांडे एंड दिस वीडियो वी आर गोइंग टू टॉक अबाउट प्लांट्स एंड सराउंडिंग एंड एनवायरनमेंट। दिस टॉपिक इज टेकन फ्रॉम फोर्थ स्टैंडर्ड साइंस फ्रॉम एसचन पब्लिकेशन टेक्स्ट बुक ऑफ ICSE बोर्ड। And in this lesson, we are going to cover the objectives are introduction, the root, function of root, the shoot, the stem, function of stem, the leaf, function of leaf, photosynthesis, how plants use food, transpiration, and also plants' products. Now let's discuss about introduction of the lesson. Just like our body is made up of several parts and each part has its own work to do, same way, the bodies of other living beings also have several parts. Let's see what the different parts of plants are, and also we will discuss about what they does. We already know that a portion of the plant grow above the ground is called as shoot, and the portion that grow below the soil is called root. Which we can see in this image, the part which is growing above the ground is called as shoot system, and the part of the plant which is growing under the ground is called as root system. Now we will talk about the root of the plant. Roots are of different kind. The same plants have thick root that go deep into the soil. Other plants have a number of thin short roots. There are two kinds of root, tap roots and fibrous roots, which we can see in this image. This is called as a tap root and this is called as a fibrous root. Now let's talk in deep about them. In a tap root, there is a main thick root growing from the end of the stem. So this is the end of the stem from where the main thick root is growing. And several thin roots grow from the main root, as we can see in this image. Plants like beans, peas, balsam and mustard have tap roots. Now let's discuss about fibrous root. In fibrous root, a number of equal size roots grow from the end of the stem. As we can see in this image, number of roots are going from the end of the stem. So there is no main root. Grass, wheat, rice and onion have fibrous root. Now let's discuss about the function of the root. Root fix a plant firmly to the soil. Roots help the plant take water and mineral from the soil. In some plants such as carrot, radish and beetroot, the food prepared by the plant is stored in the root and we eat these roots. Now let's talk about the shoot. The shoot has stem, branches, leaves, buds, flowers and fruits in them. Fruits have seeds inside them and from these seeds the new plants grow. Now we will talk about stem in detail. The stem supports the plants above the ground. Branches, leaves, buds, fruits and flowers grow on end. Trees usually have hard, woody, strong stem. The stems are covered with thick bark. Such a stem is called a trunk. Bushes such as rose and hibiscus have thin and hard stem. Herbs such as tomato and mint have soft, green stem. Creepers such as strawberry and climbers such as money plant have weak stems. They cannot hold the plant upright. Creepers spread on the ground and climbers need support to climb. Now we will discuss about the function of the stem. The stem gives support to the plant above the ground. The water taken in by the root of the plant travels to all parts of the plant, including the leaves through the stem. Leaves use this water to make food. As we can see in this image, the waters are taken in by the root of the plant and it reaches to all part of a plant. And especially leaves use this water to make the food. The food made by the leaves is required by all parts of the plant. It travels through the stem to all parts. As we can see in this image, the water from the ground is taken in by the root of the plant, which is transferred to all parts of a plant, and the leaves, by using the sunlight, making the food, which is again transferred through the stem to all parts of the plant. Sometimes the food made by the leaves is stored in the stem, as in sugarcane. Potato and ginger are also stems that store food. They are underground stems. We eat this stem. And bamboo is the fastest growing woody plant in the world. It can grow 35 inches in a day. Now we will talk about the leaf. Leaves are of many different shape and size, but they are mostly green in color, as we can see in this down image. But all the plants doesn't have the leaves and green color. Some are having red, some pale yellow or yellow in color. The flat part of a leaf is called leaf blade. The main veins or midrib is a thin tube that runs through the middle of the leaves, which we can see in all these leaves. The middle part of the leaves are called as midrib or main vein, and the side veins are thinner tubes that come out of the midribs and spread throughout the leaf blade, which we can see over here, the side veins, which is attached to the main veins or midrib. It is through these veins that water is carried to the leaf. They also carry food from the leaf to all parts of the plant. The leaf blades have thin opening on its underside called stomata, and singularly it is called as stoma, which we can see in this image. The plant takes in and gives out air through the stomata. Excess of water is also given out through the stomata. Now let's discuss the function of the leaf. A leaf makes food for the plant. In fact, plants make food for the entire living world in their leaves. Plants are the only living things that make food from non-living things, that is, air, sunlight, water, and also by using some minerals present in the soil. Now let's discuss about the photosynthesis, which is a process of making food in plants. Leaves are mostly green in color because of a substance called chlorophyll, which we can see in this image. Chlorophyll is necessary for the leaves to make food. That is why only green color plants can make food. The leaves put together carbon dioxide from the air and water from the soil to make food. This process by which food is made in the leaves is called photosynthesis. Photo means light and synthesis means putting together, which we can see in this picture that the plant is taking photos, that is light from the sun and also water and minerals from the soil, and also taking air and putting them together to make the food. During the process of photosynthesis, the food that the leaves prepare is a kind of sugar called glucose. The glucose may further change into starch before the plant stores it in fruits, stem, roots, or leaves. During photosynthesis, the gas oxygen is also produced, which we can understand from this image, where we can see that the plant is taking sunlight, carbon dioxide, water and minerals from the soil and making the food in the form of sugar, which is called as glucose. And also plant is releasing oxygen into the atmosphere. It is given off into the atmosphere through the stomata. Oxygen is necessary for all plants and animals to breathe. Plants are the only living things that replace oxygen that other living things use up. They also use up the carbon dioxide that other living things give out. That is why we say that plants clean the air. At night, when there is no sunlight, plants do not make food. They then breathe in oxygen and give out carbon dioxide as animals do. Now let's see how plants use food. Plants need food like animals too, but they prepare more food than is needed by them. Plants need energy to grow and to produce flowers, fruits, seeds, and more leaves. This energy is produced by food they prepare, which is prepared by the process of photosynthesis. Plants use light energy and carbon dioxide present in the atmosphere, and they also use water and minerals from their roots to make their food. And they make the food in the form of glucose, and during this process they give out oxygen in the atmosphere. And the food prepared by them is used for growth and to repair damage. For example, if an animal eats a portion of a plant, which we can see in this image, the plant can make new body parts to repair the damage. The extra food prepared by the plant is stored in different parts, such as fruit, stem, root, seed, or leaves. Humans and other animals eat this food. Now we will discuss about transpiration, releasing water vapor. Another function of the leaf is to release extra water in the form of water vapor. This is called transpiration. The water vapor is released from the stomata in the leaf. Let's understand from this image. When we give water to the plant and it gets extra in amount, then the stored water in the plant released by the stomata of the leaf in the form of water vapor. And this is called as transpiration. Transpiration helps in cooling down the plants. Also, as water goes out from the leaves, the roots pull more water from the soil and send it to the leaves. This water brings with it nutrients from the soil, which are required by the plant. You can do simple experiment to study about the transpiration, and that is, take a small potted plant and water it. Cover it with a transparent plastic bag, as we can see in this image. Now tie the mouth of the bag and keep the plant in the sun. Observe after few hours, can you see water droplets in the plastic bag? Yes, you can. So where did the water vapor come from? The water vapor comes from the leaves of the plant. It was already present in the leaves of the plant, which was released in the form of water vapor. Now let's discuss about the plant's product we use in our day-to-day lives. So the very first product is food. We get many kinds of food items from plants. Many kinds of fruits, vegetables, grains, and pulses. Oils such as groundnut oil, coconut oil, sunflower oil, and mustard oil. Even peanut oil, soybean oil, olive oil, all the oils we get from the plant. Spices such as pepper, turmeric, clove, cardamom, etc. All the spices we get from the plant. Tea, coffee, cocoa, even sugarcane for sugar we get from the plant. Next product is wood, which we get from trees. It is used to make houses, furniture, and many other items, as we can see in this image of furnitures in the house. It is also used for firewood. Plants also give us fibers. Cotton fibers come from the cotton plant. This is a cotton bud which give us cotton fiber. And jute fibers come from jute plant, and also cord from coconut, as we can see in this image. We get medicines from plants such as neem, tulsi, turmeric, eucalyptus, and poppy, as we can see in this image. Apart from these, we also get aloe vera, peppermint, marigold, lemon, lavender, rosemary. These all plants are also coming under medicinal plants. We get perfume from flowers such as rose, jasmine, and lavender. So So we also get perfume from plants. Next product we get from plant is rubber. We get rubber from rubber plant, as we can see in this image. It is used to make tires and erasers. We get paper mainly from bamboo plant, as we can see in this image. Now let's discuss about the summary of the video. In this video, we have studied about the shoot system and root system of the plant. In the root system, we have studied that there are two types of root, fibrous root and tap root. Then we have studied about the stem of the plant and then about the leaves of the plant. And then we studied about photosynthesis. And then we talked about transpiration in a plant. And after that, we studied about the products we get from the plant, that is food, wood, fibers, medicine, perfume, rubber, and paper. These are the products we get from the plant. Thank you for watching my video. Please like, share, and subscribe my channel. And even don't forget to press the bell icon to get the latest update of my channel.